Everyone, how's it going today? I'm Crypto Foxy, and thank you so much for stopping by my channel. So in this video, we're going to have a quick look at Caspa and look at a price prediction surrounding Caspa's price, and also look at the technicals that they're using to determine this price prediction. And we're going to look at the chart to see where we're sitting at today. So let's jump into it in this video. Smash the like button and subscribe to my channel for more cryptocurrency news and information. I cover Caspa all the time because I truly believe that Caspa is a great long-term hold. This is just my opinion, however. None of this is financial advice whatsoever. Cryptocurrencies are highly volatile and things can sometimes go either way. The overall market is, I believe it's a bit down today because of CPI data in the US has come in a little tiny bit hot and it's not overly crazy. However, I don't think that it's going to really negatively impact the market for too long. I think right now price is just digesting what's happening. So that's just my opinion. However, so let's get into it here. So the sentiment, overall sentiment for Caspa is bullish. The fear and greed index is in extreme greed right now. We have some key support levels we're going to talk about and some resistance levels to watch as well. The Caspa price prediction is expected to reach the price of 19.7 cents by March 16th. So we have, you know, about 4 days to get there. I'm Canadian. So this would represent a 30% price increase for Caspa in the next 5 days. This was written yesterday. So Caspa has been displaying positive trend recently as the coin gained almost 12% in the last 30 days. The midterm trend for Caspa has been bullish. Caspa is increasing by 33.3% in the last 3 months. And the long-term picture for Caspa has been very positive. Just to note, it has been up a staggering almost 1,200% in the one-year price change. So the technical analysis for today, March 12th, is currently bullish and the fear and greed index is reading extreme greed. Support levels to watch are around 14.4 cents, 14 cents, and 13.6 cents, while 15.2, 15.6, and 16 are the key resistance levels. So if we get a bump up to any of these numbers right here, we could see some profit taking, maybe a little, bit of a sell-off if we can't, obviously gain and hold that position. Well, they're also using 21 indicators to come to this conclusion. They're signaling bullish predictions for Caspa, while 4 indicators that they're using are showing a bearish forecast, with 84% of indicators favoring a bullish positive prediction. So that's something to note as well. So they do actually list the indicators and such that they are looking at down here in this list. I'm not going to go through them all because they're quite technical and most people don't even really understand what they mean. So it is important to note that they basically cut it down in simple terms for us so we don't have to really know all that stuff. So more important, the technical indicators are signaling bullish momentum. So we can see here their value. They're using the RSIs, they're using momentum, MACD, all the good stuff that most people in technical analysis use. They are also looking at the simple moving averages, and those are the ones, those are two that are showing bearish signals. It's trending below the 50-day SMA and the 200-day SMA. So that is currently showing a bearish price prediction. However, the whole, the long-term projection for Caspa is showing bullish, and that's what really matters to me, in my opinion. They would have to increase by 30% to hit their target on the 16th. Let's go over, we're going to jump over and look at the chart here on the 4 hour. So this was back on February 7th. I started a, to see how much we moved up since then. And we are sitting at about 36%, it's 36%, almost 37 since February the 7th. So Caspa has been on this little bit of a curve up here. So we moved up very, very nicely, kind of consolidated a little bit. Now we're trending downwards a little bit. So, we're going to obviously keep an eye on the resistance lines, the support lines to see if it bounces. We're obviously looking at getting in right around here, around the 14.4. Looks like it's some pretty good support right there. So that's what, we're basically going to watch and see what happens with Caspa. Obviously it is lacking some tier one exchanges. I think we have a lot of catalysts in the future for Caspa coming. So we're not quite there yet. However, Caspa definitely has a long-term outlook because of its technicals, not because of the technical analysis, but because the fundamentals behind Caspa coin. I think, it has a lot of similarities to Bitcoin. It has, you know, even some differences in Bitcoin, the things that needed to be addressed with the Bitcoin, with Bitcoin, if you want to use it for, you know, purchases and such like that. It's a great store of value. However, it lacked a lot of different scalability options, which Caspa solves. So that's something that Caspa definitely has going for it. And I think it's got a bright future ahead. So none of this is financial advice whatsoever. Like I mentioned, you know, technical analysis is just one tool we use to determine price action. And so that's what I got for you guys in this video. I'll make sure to update you if anything else changes, and I hope you have a great day.